The Crab Nebula. In 1054 AD, a massive supernova in the constellation of Taurus was seen from Urantia. Chinese astronomers documented the event, describing it as a guest star that was visible for nearly 2 years. References to the event are also found in a Japanese document and a document from the Middle East. Pictographs from an ancestral Puebloan culture in what is now New Mexico suggest those people may have witnessed the event as well. That event faded from view and faded from memory until 1731, when the Crab Nebula was discovered. In 1921, speculation emerged that the Crab Nebula was created by a supernova event. In 1942, it had been shown beyond a reasonable doubt that the supernova of 1054 was responsible for the creation of the Crab Nebula. Next came the task of determining why the Crab Nebula was so irregular compared to other nebulae formed by supernovae.
As a rule, the vast extrusion of matter continues to exist about the residual cooling sun as extensive clouds of nebular gases. And all this explains the origin of many types of irregular nebulae, such as the Crab Nebula, which had its origin about 900 years ago, and which still exhibits the mother sphere as a lone star near the center of this irregular nebular mass.
In 1968, the star at the center of the Crab Nebula was discovered. A neutron star, the remaining core of the original star that went supernova. A neutron star is the smallest and densest stellar object known to exist. A single teaspoon could have as much mass as an entire mountain. Neutron stars spin very rapidly. The star in the Crab Nebula rotates at a rate of over 30 times per second. Not only is it a neutron star, it is a special kind called a pulsar. Pulsars are highly magnetic and emit beams of electromagnetic energy from their magnetic poles. Further study of the Crab Pulsar led to understanding why the Crab Nebula is so irregular. The high-speed rotation kicks up plasma winds that slam into the surrounding gas. Pulsing bursts of radiation, coupled with high levels of magnetism, cause arcing webs in the nebular dust and gas. Even though the Crab Pulsar is only about the size of Manhattan, it is 100,000 times more energetic than our Sun. As a result, the nebula shines brighter than 75,000 suns. The Crab Pulsar generates enough energy to keep the entire nebula radiating over almost the entire electromagnetic spectrum. The wonders of creation never cease to amaze.